In this section, we're going to be covering the pen and the node tool because they work seamlessly together really well. Just to note that I have made a very in-depth tutorial on the pen and node tool, so you can go and check that out. This will be for the basics, okay? So you can get a good understanding of how this works. So we'll start off with selecting the pen tool. And like always, it's on the left-hand side in the tools panel. And as I hover over it, the shortcut is P on the keyboard. So I'm going to select it. And the first thing I'm going to do is check my fill and my stroke. Of course, I've already done it, but for fill right now, because we're just drawing these strokes, these outlines, we want to set the fill to none. So we just click on this button here, and then we go over to stroke, choose your color, and then we go over to the width, and let's place it on 25. Okay, and then click off of that. Let's begin. So to start off with, I'm just going to click once and then twice. So in its default state, this is how it will work. So you have two squares either end. These are called sharp nodes, and they're called sharp nodes because there's no curvature in this line. So that's what we're going to concentrate on to begin with before we go up to the context toolbar and look at all those options. So I'll zoom out and we'll just keep drawing out these sharp nodes. So I'll click again and again and again, and you see there's no curves anywhere. I'm just clicking once, twice, three times, etc. So these are all sharp nodes, and this blue line is our path. So if you look in the layers panel, we have one layer, that's our sharp nodes layer. And let's say we want to start drawing out another line. Well, if I just start drawing over here, if I click once more, you see, actually, it still thinks I want to continue drawing that. So I'll press Command Z to go back a step. From this point, you just want to press Escape. So if I press Escape now, you see the node, it changed color. That means that Affinity knows now that I'm finished with that line for now. So let's start drawing these smooth nodes. So to begin with, I will just click, and this time I will drag. And you see this? It's a circle, and that is called a smooth node. And these handles each side are called handles. So from this point, I can just let go. See, I've drawn it out like that. And this is the trajectory of the line. So if I click around here, and I click and drag, you see, it was going to be pointing up that way because that's the way the handle was facing. Okay, so let's keep drawing those out. So I'll click drag again. And you see, I could drag it really far and change it like this. So I'll just keep doing this. So we're only using smooth nodes right now. And they've got handles on them as well. Those handles mean that we can play around with them later. That's where the node tool comes in. But for now, we'll just use the pen tool in its basic default state. So I want to create a new line now. I have two layers. I press Escape. Let's mix it up a bit. So this time I will start off with a sharp node. So I'll click once, and I'll click once again there. And then this time I will click and drag. And you see we've got a kind of wave shape going on here. I'll let go, and I'll go to about here, and I'll click and drag. And I'll do the same again here. And then from here, I'll just click once. And you see, when I click once, it's just a sharp node. If I don't drag, it will end up being a sharp node. And then if I click once more, there we go. So we've used sharp and smooth nodes in the same line. Okay, let's press Escape so we can draw a new line. And this time I want to concentrate on those sharp corners, those cusps. So this is where it gets a little bit more technical, okay? So we'll click once and we will click and drag this time here. Really, when you start, you should click and drag if you want that to be smooth to begin with, and then click and drag again. Okay, so we have two smooth nodes there. But what if I wanted that to be sharp now, just remaining in the pen tool? Well, there's an easy way. You just press Alt or Option on your keyboard. And you see, as I hover over this handle, if I hold Alt or Option, see this little pointy icon appears. Basically, that's telling me I can get rid of that handle. So I'm going to click once, and now you see it's turned into a sharp node. So from this point, I can click and drag, and you see now I have a sharp cusp there, a sharp corner, and I can go up and make another smooth one. And let's say from this point, actually, we want another sharp one. Okay, let's just do it one more time. Option and click, and then drag. Like this. There is another way as well, which I'll show you on the next wave, I guess. So if we click and drag to make another smooth node, before we let go, we can hold down Option And then we can just drag this handle to where kind of we want the next path to lead. So if I let go at this point, see it's facing down there. If I just click and drag here, you can see initially it wanted to go this way, and now I'm dragging this way, it's going in this curvature. So let's do that one more time. So I'll go up here, and then I'll hold option, I'll drag it around, I'll let go, and then I'll click and drag like that. So there's some of the basics of using the pen tool. So here's a scenario when you first start using the pen tool. You'll be clicking along as I showed you just now, and then you'll press escape because you're like, I want to draw a new line. And then you'll start drawing that new line, and then you'll think, oh no, actually I wanted to continue drawing along the first line. How do I do that? Well, of course, we'll press Command Z to get rid of those previous steps. So how do I continue drawing from this node here? Well, it's simple. You just hold down Command and then you go ahead and select the node. And now you can see it's changed color. And that means I can continue drawing. So click, 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 click. So right now, this is considered an open curve because I haven't completed the shape yet. So I'll just show you by adding a fill. So I'll just make that some kind of yellow color there. And I'll just go back down. I'll just hold down Command and tap on that little one again so it knows that I want to continue to draw out from there. So right now it's open and you can see the fill. Yeah, it's kind of looking a bit odd really, isn't it? What we want to do is complete the shape. So as I hover over the first node that I started drawing from, you can see a little icon. It's a circle. It's basically telling us the circle will be complete if we click here. So I will. And now this is called a closed curve. We've completed the shape. So this shape that we've just drawn out is all sharp, right? It's sharp nodes all around. And a little taster into the node tool at this point, because the node tool and the pen tool, they work together so closely that you almost don't realize you're using the node tool sometimes. So let's say this node here, it's sharp right now. What if we wanted to turn it into a smooth node? Well, you just hold down Command or Control on a PC, and you just hover over. But you see, before I hover over, this is turned into the node tool now, just so I could select this node. So I'll click on it, and then I'll let go. You see, I'm still in the pen tool, and I still have the pen tool's context toolbar options. I can go over to Convert. Right now, sharp, it's already sharp, so we don't want that. We can go to Smooth and click on that. Great, it's now a smooth node, and that's what we wanted. Okay, let's have a look at the different modes in the context toolbar. So the one we started off with, the one I've shown you so far, is just pen mode, this one here. So obviously we can do sharp nodes like that. We can click and drag to get those smooth nodes and so on. So I'll just delete that and we'll check the next one. So this is called smart mode and it works slightly differently. So if I just click once, you can see it's a round circle, looks like a smooth node, but it has a little dot inside of it. And if I just click once more up here, I can see it already has handles on it, looks slightly different. This is smart mode, remember? And when I click once more, you see it's kind of worked out for itself what the curvature should be on this path. And you can just keep clicking around like this, and it will automatically decide how smooth each one should be. And I'll finish the shape there, and there we go. So that's smart mode. I'll press delete on that one. So the next mode is polygon mode. And basically, this one is going to allow us just to draw in sharp, straight lines. And even if I click to drag to get that smooth node, it will not let me. So you can just click around like this, and you're never getting a smooth node. Okay, next mode, let's have a look, and it is line mode. So this one, I'll click once, click twice, click three times. Oh. Click four times, so it only allows us to draw individual straight lines. So I could do that. It's not going to continue along. So this could be quite handy if you're doing a lot of straight line work, I guess. Press Command Z to go back, get rid of those. The last part I want to show you is this one right at the end here. It's called rubber band mode. And if I select that one, and we'll go back to our original pen mode. So this one is quite cool, actually. So if I click once here, and you see here, it's just this line is already here. I will click once again. And then let's say I do a smooth node here. When I let go, it kind of has this projection line. So it's kind of showing me what the curvature will be like if I tap here. So I'll do another smooth node here. And this time I'll end with a sharp node. So you see the curvature here? If I click, it was exactly as it projected. So obviously now that I've got a sharp node, it's gone to a straight line. So I can just click once here. But if I just click and drag There, it already knows I'm in the smooth node and it will give me that projection line again. Very handy. So whilst I still have this shape open, I just want to show you an action that you can perform. So I haven't closed the curve yet, but I can go up to action and just press a button and it will do it for me. So I can press close curve just up here. When I click it, it just knows exactly where the start and end node was and just fills it in. Okay, let's briefly cover snapping whilst we're in the pen tool. So we can enable snapping here, but first of all, I'll try and draw something without snapping. So imagine I want to draw a straight line out like this, and I want it to be perfectly down in line with that. Well, nothing's happening, there's nothing snapping. So I can just go up here and I can turn on this one here. It says align to nodes of the selected curve. So I can click on that. And now if I keep drawing, you see, as I hover over here, this little line tells me I'm perfectly in line and it kind of magnetizes towards here. So I could just click once here. And when I go up, you see here, it's snapping to this node over on the left-hand side and it's showing me the dimensions between. You see here, the dimensions of the vertical and horizontal. And I could just continue now and everything's perfectly in line. So this could be very useful for you to use this. And of course, there are other snapping options. If you want to know and go further in detail with that, go and check out my full tutorial. And of course, right at the end, you can click use fill or don't use fill. But you can also just do it from here, fill, like I did at the start. Okay, now I want to show you how you can just use the shift key to get perfectly straight lines. So I'll click once there. And I'll plan to drop my node over here somewhere. But as I don't have snapping on, I can just hold down shift and we get this yellow line here. So I could just click there and I know I've got two perfectly lined up sharp nodes with a completely straight path. And this also works vertically as well. So I can do that again. And also it works when you're going up at an angle. As you can see, I'll just go around like a clock. So what I want to do now is just click on snapping and use both of them together. So that snapping is highlighted and I will just hold down shift and click until I go up until it lines up with that node just over there. So there it is. So now I can just click and I know that's perfectly lined up. So I've created a little assault course to test out all the things I've been talking about. So I'm in the pen tool and just the pen mode, nothing else is selected. So here we go. Let's zoom into the first one. So this one, these all look like they should be sharp nodes. So I'm just going to click once there and once there, and I'll just keep clicking on each of these points because there's no curves here whatsoever. So that was pretty easy enough. So let's go to the next one. In order to draw a new line, I have to press escape. Okay, let's go down here and see what this is about. So I know that I need to click and drag out a smooth node here. And maybe about here, I will click and drag again. And then it looks like it just goes down and up here. So I'm going to click and drag from there as well. So from this point, I can get rid of this handle. So remember, you can press Option and you can click on the handle and that's got rid of it. So now it's just a straight line going across, but how do I make sure it's a straight line? Well, I can either use the snapping option or the shift option. So remember the shift option here? I'm going to use that one this time. So I'm going to hold down shift and I'm going to click where I think it ends there. This is another sharp node scenario. So I'll click once there. And this one here is definitely a curve. So what I can do is click like this and can let go, and I'll do the same thing again. Option, click on the handle, and then this time I'm not going to use shift. I'm going to go up to snapping, click that on, and I just want to be able to go in a straight line and end about there. So that was relatively easy. Okay, great. Let's move on to this. So we've got a wave and a sun. So this sun is just a perfect circle there. I'm going to press escape so I can draw that new line. So I'll try and figure out where the center is here. So I'm going to click and drag out. And I want to make sure that it's level. So remember, I can hold down shift and that will level it out. And I've just kind of got to decide how far I should pull out. So this circle is going to have about 4 nodes on it. So I'm going to click about here and drag out. Oh, look, I was almost right. I'll go down to the center here. And now look, because snapping is still turned on, I know that that is the center. So click and drag out whilst holding shift. Okay, and up here, it's snapping, so I can click, hold down shift and drag up. And the last one, I can click and drag. There we go. So that's not too bad. It's not perfect, I messed up a little bit there. That's where the node tool will come in, which is next. So on the last one, let's try and tackle this wave. So because I closed that last shape, I no longer need to press escape. So I'll click once there, I'll drag to about there, and then I will drag out whilst holding shift so everything stays in line, and I'll let go. So around about here, I think, I will click and drag like that. And then on the last point, I will click and drag like this. And before I let go, because I know there's a cusp coming up, I can hold down the Option key and I can drag it around to where I think it should be. So maybe somewhere like that. I'll let go and I'll place my new one about here. I'll click and drag it there, almost perfect. And I can do the same up here, just click and drag until I get to this section here, and I just click and drag out like that. So I know I need to go straight down, so I'm going to hold down Option, click on that handle to get rid of it. So from this point, I think I'll just hold down Shift and to about here. And because snapping is turned on, I'll need this now. So I'll just go over to this node and you see it's kind of meeting up. I'll click and then I could just complete the wave. So that didn't work out too bad, actually. Let's move on to the node tool to see how that can help us.